Are you ready for solar-powered mobility?
Yeah.
자동차 회사들 지금 큰일 났어요. 중국 자동차들 엄청나거든요. 오직감이 현대차의 정의선 회장이 직원들한테 너희 충격 좀 받으라고. 중국의 지커 자동차, 지리 자동차의 고급 버전이거든요. 제네시스 같은 거예요. 얘네들이 지금 자동차를 너무 잘 만들어서 이걸 갖다 놓고 분석을 하고 있어요. 도요타 같은 경우에도 이번에 5년 만에 CES 와가지고 한다는 게 우븐 시티라는 걸 만든다고 해요. 뭐 스마트 시티 같은 건데 되게 뜬금없잖아요. 갑자기 도요타가 도시를 만든다? 되게 뜬금없죠. 그런데 또 대박인 건요, 현대차가 자동차 파운드리를 하게 될 겁니다. 실제로 지금 구글에서 현대차한테 자동차를 만들어 달라고 지금 맡기고 있고 파운드리 업체로 선정이 됐어요. 보통 반도체 같은 경우에는 칩 설계도를 갖다 주면 칩을 만들어주는 파운드리 업체가 존재하잖아요. 삼성 파운드리라든가 TSMC처럼. 이제는 근데 현대차가 그런 자동차 파운드리 역할을 하게 될까요? 왜 이렇게 바뀌고 있냐? 지금 전통의 자동차 회사들이 아니 주가가 안 올라가. 토요타, 현대차 아니 주가가 PER이 너무 낮아요. 테슬라 같은 경우는 거의 100도 왔다 갔다 하는데 전통의 자동차 업체들은 PER이 5밖에 안 되는 거야. 그러다 보니까 야 이대로 가면 안 된다 이런 생각이 들어서 여러 가지들을 시도하고 있는데, 하지만 테슬라 같은 경우는 물론 알고 있습니다. 전통의 가치 판단 기준 어렵다는 거. 그리고 지금 테슬라 살람 좀 무섭잖아요. 너무 많이 올랐어. 그러다 보니까 미국에서는 야 그 다음 테슬라가 어디가 될까, 그 다음 자동차 좀 대세는 뭐가 될까 많이 이제 탐색을 하고 있는데, 근데 제가 예전에 소개 드렸던 자동차 회사가 한 군데 있어요. 거기가 여기 와 있다고 하고 이번에 최초로 공개했다고 하더라고요. 근데 더 대박인 거는 요 PR 담당자님께서 제 영상을 보셨어. 그래서 한번 이제 인터뷰도 딸 수 있게 또 이제 탈 수 있게 해준다 하셔가지고 그쪽으로 가보려고 합니다. 지금 전통차 자동차들이 모습을 바꾸고 있는 현 상황에서 치고 올라오고 있는 스타트업들은 뭐라고 있는지 한번 보러 가보시죠.
So this is Aptera. Yeah. It's the world's first solar electric vehicle.
Okay. Yeah.
This is now a validation vehicle. It has all production parts.
Yeah.
For the vehicle. And we're hoping to get these in customers' hands by the end of the year. I believe that solar-powered cars could become mainstream.
Yeah.
And that's because it offers you extended freedom that you don't have with other electric vehicles.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I think a barrier to entry for a lot of people with electric vehicles is range anxiety, how long it takes to charge.
Yeah.
And with Aptera, you can plug it in just like any other EV, but you can also supplement with the solar power that's on the body of the vehicle. And so if you are out of range of an electric charger and you're not able to get to one, the solar power offers you freedom there. A lot of times people are just leaving their cars while they're out at work, so you can get additional range every single day, whether you're parking for the grocery store or for work. And you can come back to your vehicle with more range than when you left it.
But the biggest problem is the price. How much is it?
Aptera, we're targeting $40,000.
$40,000.
Yeah, exactly. Because Aptera is so efficient, it takes a lot less batteries to power our vehicle forward. And in most electric vehicles, the most expensive part of them is the battery. So because we only take a third of the energy of traditional vehicles, Aptera can actually be quite a bit more accessible in terms of price point.
Then this is my personal question. Why should the customer choose Aptera over Tesla in 5 or 10 years later?
I believe Aptera is the best choice because it's a true zero emission vehicle. It's the best form of transportation that we have right now for our planet.
Yep.
We'll be able to build a car that can just drive purely from solar energy, and you won't have to make an impact, a negative impact on our planet. The benefit of Aptera is being able to charge in remote places that might not have charging infrastructure. Yeah. We also don't have to tax the electric grid, which has been a huge issue, at least in the United States. We don't have enough charging infrastructure to power all of the electric vehicles on the road. So I think that's a massive benefit of Aptera. But one of my personal favorites is that Aptera actually has a huge trunk.
Yeah,
it comes with a camping
huge.
Kit,
yeah.
And you can actually sleep in the back to go camping for your solar-powered adventure.
So when do
you... Is it a car or a flying vehicle?
It's a car, yeah. It's a vehicle.
Then,
is it flying?
Yeah.
It's not flying.
It's not flying car. Yeah, it's
not
it's
yet.
A solar panel car.
Oh wow.
It looks like a flying car.
It does. Yeah. People do ask if it flies.
Maybe this will be your next.
Maybe step. The next generation.
Next generation, really?
Potentially.
Then when do you think we will see this on the market?
We're hoping to begin production by the end of 2025, so you'll really start to see customer deliveries in 2026 in the United States.
Okay.
We have 50,000 pre-orders for the vehicle, and those are from people all over the world. We're going to be launching in the United States first and foremost, but we really hope to make our way to other countries as well.
Then this is our last question. What kind of car do you drive these days?
Personally?
Yeah.
I drive a Tesla Model S.
Tesla.
It's a 2014.
Why? Yeah.
The reason I drive it is because I was grandfathered into the free supercharging because the vehicle's a decade old. It's, it's 10 years old, so I don't have to pay for charging.
I see.
And that's helpful for me because I live in an apartment and I don't have a charging.
여러분. 이분 테슬라 모델 X 타고 계신답니다.
He's gonna film in here.
근데 10년 되셨다고? 앉아볼게요.
I'm Quincy. One second.
Okay.
Thanks, you can go.
It also looks like a Tesla, very simple.
Yes, very simple design. We're kind of modeling off of a lot of modern electric vehicles. You do all of the controls from the UI for the most part, except for the horn and the volume button there.
이제 Apple CarPlay or
Android CarPlay. This is the reverse camera. You want to put it in drive. It's just like that.
Then why don't you use a particular gear?
It's a great question. I don't know the answer.
Is there something reason?
Why do you think?
I don't know about that. Is there some reason?
It's simpler.
Like our Apple simple is the best.
I think so. Do you think that this interior design was inspired by the Tesla Model X at all? That's the question.
No.
Completely unique from the Model X. We take the inspiration from where we need, but we also stood on our beliefs of where the controls should be, where the touch should be, how the HVAC should be, what the vision system offers you. The answer about the yoke is, we're not the first, but we're also not really, lots of people figured this out also, and it really brings, it's better for the function, but it also brings a unique experience to the user.
Okay, I see, thank you.
Yeah.
That was our chief of design, so I wanted to make sure he answered the question. We're hoping within the first couple years of production, we'll be able to make our way to Korea, South Korea.
Yeah.
We have another partner, CTNS, that's located there, and they're doing our battery manufacturing, actually. Mm. So we're definitely hoping to make our way to South Korea early on.
Then could you give us a last comment to Korean customers?
Especially to South Korea. Yeah. I would say, are you ready for solar-powered mobility?
Yeah. Okay.